Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at grammar checking on your Mac. So here I've typed a bunch of sentences which all have grammar mistakes in them. And I've done it in TextEdit. Now in TextEdit, as you can in Mail and some other apps on the Mac, you can go to Edit and Spelling and Grammar and turn on Check Grammar with Spelling. And this will add grammar checking to the spell checker here. Instead of getting a red underline for a misspelled word, you get a green underline for something that it feels is grammatically incorrect. So how well does it work? Well, not too well, because most of the mistakes here have been missed. See, there's no magic to this. Spell checking is very easy. It simply looks at a list of words, and if it's not in the list of words, then it must be a misspelled word. Grammar checking is very difficult compared to that, because it has to look at all the context of the words around it, figure out certain rules and everything like that. So it's very difficult for a computer to actually do accurate grammar checking, as we're going to see here. So it'll do some simple things basically to help you avoid some mistakes, but it is no substitution for knowing the correct grammar yourself. So let's take a look at what it did here. It was able to correctly figure out that I used the wrong form of the word it here. And if I were actually able to roll over it, I can see that it gives me the grammar rule, or at least gives me an idea of a substitution here. I can also control click or right click on it, and I can get a substitution right there. And also select ignore grammar if I know I'm right. Because just as it won't get some errors, it will show you some that aren't really there. But here you can see it completely missed the fact that I should be using whom here. And the rest of these all have various different mistakes in it. Some are really obvious, like the wrong form of the word your should be Y-O-U apostrophe R-E. Also, like down here, I'm using the wrong to, should be T-O-O. But it did get the error here, and it did figure out here that it should be have. And it's interesting, if I control click on bin, it says it doesn't really give me any substitutions there, but it says it may not agree with what's going on. If I go over of, it says consider have, and that's where the real problem is. It should be have instead of. So how about pages? I think pages might be able to do better, but pages actually, believe it or not, doesn't have any grammar checking. Well, not at least obvious grammar checking. If you go down to edit spelling, you can see it's just missing from there. But you've got proofreading, and you can go to the proofreader here, and it will give you suggestions. So the very first suggestion here has nothing to do with grammar, just giving you a notice that nice is a weak modifier. Let's go next and see, yes, it did pick this one up. It should be have instead of. But that's it. Didn't really pick up any of the rest here. So it does do a little bit of grammar, but certainly not enough here. So you think the best app for this might be Microsoft Word. After all, it's been around for so long, so many versions of Microsoft Word. They've had plenty of time to improve it. And sure enough, when I put the same text in here, I can see it gets a lot more, but not everything. It gets the its, gets the who, and it also figures out right here, like things which, if I control click on it, it'll say things that. It figures out that it should be nor instead of or here. It misses some of these. Get to this one here, and it figures out here this should be have, very nice, and even figures out this should be T-O-O. So it's better than the rest, but still not perfect. Even this web-based app where I was able to copy and paste some text into, it didn't catch everything. You can see it got a few of the things in here. And you can see each one of these, this website and Word and pages and just text edit, got something different. So you can see they're all using different ways of checking for grammar. So the conclusion is there's no foolproof way to have your Mac check your grammar for you. You have to know the grammar yourself, but you can have these grammar checkers as kind of a backup. Actually, they're more useful as spell checkers, because when you spell a word incorrectly, but you spell it so that it's a different word, it won't catch it because it's a correctly spelled word. But a grammar checker may see that as completely not making any sense because you're using the wrong word there, and may give you that green underline so that you can then identify that you've put the wrong word there or misspelled a word and make the correction. So a grammar checker is actually more useful as a spell checker, and also it'll help with some general rules. And keep in mind, just because some of the examples I showed didn't catch common grammar mistakes doesn't mean that grammar mistake isn't in those databases. It's just that perhaps the sentence, the way I phrased it, it didn't trigger it. So you might find, for instance, that it might catch T-O-O instead of T-O or vice versa in another circumstance, just not the one I used. So I hope you found this useful. There's certainly no reason not to have this turned on, so at least you can maybe catch a few more grammar mistakes than you wouldn't otherwise. But it's also not a good idea to rely on this at all for actually checking your grammar. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.